Well, during the fall assembly of the U.S. bishops, Kevin spoke with Bishop Wack on his series, which aired here on Catholic TV, on the topic of the real presence in the Eucharist. Let's listen in.
He's of Pensacola, Tallahassee. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
We're here to talk a little bit about a video series on Eucharist, and I know everybody's been talking about a recent poll about Catholics not believing in the real presence, too. Talk about the importance of the Eucharist, why you felt this video series would be a benefit for Catholics to be able to sort of reconnect with that, real presence.
Sure. Well, it is the source and summit of our lives, of course, as Catholic Christians. And so it's disturbing that so many people said that they either don't know about or don't believe in the real presence. I hope it's they don't know about, that it's just somewhat there's some ignorance there. But it's incumbent upon us, and especially me as a bishop, as the chief catechist of the diocese, to make sure people know, to get that teaching out there.
And talk about the series itself. What do people see in the series?
Well, so we wanted to teach on the real presence, and it can be kind of a dry subject. So we didn't, at first I said, well, we have to have videos about a half hour long or something like that. And fortunately, the people in the diocese, the communications people, said, no, 3 minutes, we're going to go with that. And so that's what we do. We have three videos of about 3 minutes long, one to talk about the nature of the real presence, that it really is the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus, not a symbol or a sign. The second one is a how to receive. I think we just assume people learn that when they're young and they know it the rest of their lives, but I try to correct a lot of mistakes that people make. And then the third one is, what does the Eucharist do for us? It should, it forgives us our sins, it strengthens us, it protects us against future sins, and then it sends us out. We are the presence of Christ, the real presence in the world.
Yeah, and maybe if you could expand on that, Bishop, too, and the importance of recognizing that and how important that can be in people's faith lives to sort of shine that light to others who may not believe or just not practicing.
Exactly, yeah. We come to Mass, we prepare ourselves to receive the Eucharist, and then we say, Lord, I'm not worthy. He makes us worthy. We receive. But then the real work begins. We take his real presence out into the world. That's why if it's just a symbol, if it's just a sign, then we're only symbolically connected to the Lord. And we take the gospel out symbolically. But if it really is the real presence, then we now have that within us to go out into the world to be like Christ or to be Christ for others in the world.
Talk about putting the series together. What was it like for you? Have you done something like this before? Or?
We're doing more and more with social media and videos. Every 2 weeks I send a video, a short video, to all the priests in the diocese, just checking in, telling them what's on my mind and maybe informing them of things coming up and challenging them on some things, but it's really neat. So we use video a lot. Had not done a series like this. We thought, we'll just put it out there and see what happens. And the response has been really, really overwhelming.
How important is it to have tools like this, such as social media and video, to be able to reach people that you might not have been able to do before?
Jesus, of course, was a media person. He said the Great Commission is go out and teach and baptize all nations. I am convinced that if Twitter were invented or were, in force at that time, he would have used that. He would have used video. He would have used whatever he could. And so it's important, especially for young people today. That's where they get their main source of information is, on the internet, through video, through social media. And so we have to do that. We were just talking about that on the floor of the Bishops' Conference, about how important that is to have, not just to get out there, but to have quality video, quality blogs, things like that, so that people can take us seriously and learn about their faith and grow.
And I know you're just fairly recently a bishop. Talk to us about your experience, about the diocese itself, and what it's been like for you as the bishop of Pensacola and Tallahassee.
I think every bishop says, when they get that call from the nuncio, oh, I was so surprised. But believe me, if you knew me, you would know everyone was surprised. Even my mom said, are you sure? Everyone was really surprised. I was serving as a parish priest in Austin, Texas, and just loving it. I love being a priest. And so it was an honor, of course, but there was some grieving. It was really challenging. And the first year and a half was very challenging. We had the crisis in the church, of course, that we're still dealing with. We had Hurricane Michael that slammed into our diocese and really did a lot of damage. and some other things as well. And so that first year and a half was very, very difficult. But now, ever since our bishop's retreat in January in Mundelein, I think I've turned a corner, and I love being a priest. I'm liking being a bishop, and I'm sure I'll love it one day, but really trying to be a priest now for a larger parish that is the whole diocese.
Sure. Well, we thank you, Bishop, for being with us, and we're so happy to have the videos on Catholic TV as well. If people want to check these out, where can they go to find out about the videos?
They're through our diocesan website, ptdiocese.org.
Okay. Well, thank you so much, and I have to give a shout out to the Holy Cross Fathers as well.
Yes, I'm a Holy Cross religious.
A product of the education. So thank you so much, Bishop, for being with us today.
Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.